After decades of depredation, Louisiana's environment and the quality of our air, land, and water appeared to reach a tipping point around 2012, with the appearance of the massive sinkhole at Bayou Corn in August of that year. As disturbing as the sinkhole itself was, even more alarming was the revelation that the state officials of the Department of Natural Resources and the Office of Conservation knew about the problems of the Texas Brine Salt Dome storage cavern for at least 18 months before the sinkhole appeared. But they had engaged in a conspiracy of silence with the company against property owners, emergency responders, and law enforcement agencies in Assumption Parish. The extent to which state government sided with the industry against the interests of the people of Louisiana became crystal clear in the summer of 2013 after the Southeast Louisiana Flood Protection Authority, East, filed suit against 97 oil and gas companies for coastal damages resulting from the failure of those companies to comply with the terms of permits they had signed in order to undertake operations in Louisiana's coastal wetlands. Immediately, the levee authority came under withering political attacks from the governor, the Coastal Restoration Authority, and the oil and gas industry's lobbying groups. Resources were marshaled to replace levee authority members who had voted to support the lawsuit, and legislation was prepared to kill the lawsuit in the 2004 session of the Louisiana legislature.
The Green Army is about fighting pollution to ensure that the people of Louisiana have a human right to clean water, clean air, safe land, and safe food.
Former chief engineer for offshore operations, a guy named Bob B., a very well-known scientist, chair of the National Science Foundation team which investigated Katrina. And he won, he's now at, I guess probably America's now at Berkeley, I guess. But he, as I say, for about 20 years, he was Shell's chief offshore engineer, won many awards from the industry. In 2006, for an affidavit for the state of Louisiana, not for us, he said, clear evidence that past and current oil and gas activities have made and continue to make substantial contributions to degradations and the natural defenses against hurricane surges. All these works and activities have contributed significantly to the loss of natural defenses such as barrier, beaches, wetlands, and marshes in several important cases. It was the loss of these natural defenses that contributed to the unanticipated breaches of flood protection facilities during Hurricane Katrina.
The Green Army provided a unified voice that united those engaged in local environmental battles with those organizations that have long been involved with policy fights in Baton Rouge. Using the notoriety and respect that Honoré and Barry commanded, the Green Army quickly developed the capacity to focus local, state, and national media attention on major environmental fights in the state, as well as focus local community attention on those fights in a way that had not been previously possible.
This is a fight that we better not stop, because if we stop, what's going to happen then? But if we continue to make, to do what we're doing, it's going to get stronger.
But it's important. If you don't call it in, it didn't exist. If you don't call it in, it didn't exist.
And they said that it's not toxic or harmful to your body, but I had a double lung transplant and I just made my 2 years. It is harmful. It's harmful to me. But my immune system is lower than anyone that's with their regular lungs. We would never had anyone to come and check on it or to see about us with it. So it is harmful to me. It can cause me to have cancer of the lungs. And it may not be this year, it may not be next year, but later on I'll have it from these same chemicals that's killing me, but it takes time to show up. So I need to be protected, and if the plants are the cause of it, I need them to come out and check with us. And for nobody to be accountable for it, it's just not right. Everybody want to blame some other plant. They all are blamed if it's up to me. Because if you pass down the river road, you're smelling it from another plant. They have a different smell for each one of those plants. And something needs to be done about it.
What we want to talk about is making chemical plants safer. We know that that's possible. They work on safer chemical plants worldwide. Why do we have old chemical plants that break down in Louisiana? It's because we don't have effective government rules and regulations to really push these industries forward.
The industry in the Baton Rouge area uses 80 million gallons of groundwater a day. That's 80 million. It's not really necessary. They could get the water out of the river just as the plants do below Baton Rouge.
And so we're coming today to dump our water on the lawn. Some people say, well, hey, you're wasting that water. This water will flow into the earth, will evaporate, go back into the sky. The water that's used for hydraulic fracturing will be contaminated with radium, with barium, with heavy metals and oils, and they'll be pumped out of the hydrologic cycle forever.
Lake Kenard has been fighting for 8 years to stop the drilling of caverns to store natural gas. And the reason they're going to be taking 5 million gallons per day of water to drill these caverns. 5 million gallons of water per day for 4 years. So water is life. Thank you.
Yes.
What will you say to your grandchildren when they ask you why you allowed the earth to be fractured into so many pieces? For too long, the concerns expressed by scientists like Wilma and the general public have not been taken seriously. We are here to say that that is about to change.
Look at what's been going on over our lifetime. We can say as much as we want, but we don't have any voice in the Senate, and the legislature, and the House of Representatives. The people that have that voice is the industry. And unless we take some other approach to fighting this, I don't think just calling a senator or calling a representative is going to do anything. And I'm kind of wondering if maybe isn't this a little bit like the civil rights issues that we've had a long time ago. If they had called their congressman, if they had called their senator, would anything have changed?
No.
Go to EPA, they're working on a study that talks about the problems that may come about because of fracking. They say there are about 5 or 6 known problems that we need to deal with. If there are 5 or 6 known problems, why are we continuing to grant permits to do this type of oil drilling and gas extraction process? I think we should stop it. And I'm glad I live in a parish where people are getting together and saying we need to ban this process from our parish. We need to do it from the state. We need to do it from the nation.
What you have probably come to realize very quickly, that the state of Louisiana is work to make sure that the oil and gas company do what they want to do. And it's all about the economy. And we support the second poorest economy in the nation. And as we speak here tonight, I think the people here are saying you don't want fracking. But you're up against a big group of people. Both of your senators in Washington right now work every day to limit the powers of the EPA, as well as the Clean Water Act and the Clean Air Act. Everything that come up about those two acts, they vote against. Because they are heavily influenced by a company, by an industry that has a lot of money. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to change that in Louisiana. And it starts right here in St. Tammany Parish. Let the revolution start here.
Protecting the commons, our air, our water, and land against pollution is the core mission of the Green Army. But in a state like Louisiana, where the oil and gas industry has had its way with political and governmental processes for so long, defending the common poses a direct challenge to the political power of that industry. While the industry's political power is not questioned, its grip on the mind of the public has been revealed to be tenuous at best. This is the result of events over the past decade which have revealed for all to see the high price that state government's willingness to allow industry to go unregulated has inflicted on our communities.
We want clean water and clean air and clean food, and we're demanding it. It's our basic right. It's a right for our children and for our grandchildren.
The Green Army fights pollution, but it's also fighting to give control of Louisiana communities back to the people who live there.
Colors I wear, and you pick me out in the colors I wear. You like the simple life, everything is black or white.